Some breaking news to bring you now. Take a look at this plane right here. Emirates Air, that is the plane that the suspect in the Times Square bomb plot was about to board at Kennedy Airport last night when he was arrested. That plane still sitting on the ground at Kennedy Airport this morning.
We're back, and it sounds like something out of the Cold War. The Justice Department said today 10 people have been arrested on charges of spying for Russia.
Across the Midwest, hurricane-strength winds toppled trees that killed two people. Downed power lines caused thousands to lose power. Chicago saw 60-mile-per-hour winds and heavy rain that sent people running for cover. The winds were so strong, they blew windows out of the iconic Willis Tower. And a direct lightning strike hit this retail store, sparking a fire that engulfed the entire building in flames. In Indiana, where the winds topped 90 miles per hour, storms twisted and tangled power lines, crushing houses and cars below. One man narrowly escaped with his life after a transformer crashed through his windshield.
The past year has been dismal, to say the least, for the U.S. auto industry. Sales down dramatically, thousands of dealerships closed, GM and Chrysler forced to declare bankruptcy. Which is why today's news from Ford was all the more surprising. The company, the only automaker not taking taxpayer bailout money, posted a nearly $1 billion profit for the third quarter of the year. What's more, the company said it would be solidly profitable the year after next.
A new scare involving mail bombs erupted today in Greece. It happened just 3 days after bombs were intercepted in England and Dubai. Ray Suarez has the first of the day's two major stories.
The drama in Greece involved a parcel bomb addressed to the Mexican embassy in Athens. It exploded at a delivery service, burning one employee. Two men were arrested with more bombs, including one addressed to French President Nicolas Sarkozy.
Gold shot to a record high on Wednesday as the U.S. dollar slipped to its lowest point in more than a year. The rise of gold has been steady over the past few months, and some local experts here in Elko say there may not be an end in sight to its increase in value.
This convoy had been saying for days they were going to run the Israeli blockade of the Gaza Strip. They refused to unload 10,000 tons of humanitarian aid here at the port of Ashdod first so it could be screened so that there are no weapons in it before it went to the Gaza Strip. The Israeli Navy then approached that convoy late at night. They broadcast signals to them, talked on the radio, asking them to turn their convoy around or bring it to Ashdod. They refused. The Navy then boarded the ship. They are saying that they were absolutely overwhelmed by what they called extreme violence by the demonstrators, and that several of the Navy SEALs then were stabbed.
Thank you. Well, this next story is pretty incredible. Scientists say they found evidence that there may be signs of life on Saturn's biggest moon, Titan. Researchers analyzed data from NASA's orbiting Cassini probe of Titan, the only moon known to have a dense atmosphere. Through a complex analysis of chemicals on the surface, they believe, through their hypotheses, that the moon may harbor some form of methane-based life.
One question was raised about how would we teach our young people, and I'm a former Marine, and I became aware that there are two verses, and we need to hear the second verse, which says, "Oath thus be it ever, when free men shall stand between their loved homes and the war's desolation, blessed with victory and peace, may the heaven-rescued land praise the power that has made and preserved us a nation. Then conquer we must, when our cause it is just, and this be our motto, in God is our trust, and the star-spangled banner in triumph shall
much better than I look right now.
I'm somewhere in the future, and I look much better.